Well, still hinging your own argument on the promise made. You said, well, even that the former president, Olusegun Obasanjo, also made the same promise he was going to do a single term. Perhaps let us in on what is happening in the north as we speak, being an elder also from that particular region, as they desire to take over power in the 2015 elections. Don't you think that some other northerners will try to scuttle that same plan? It means there's no unity amongst some of the elders in the north. Do you agree with that?
Mr. Suleiman, the last time I appeared on a similar program, I made it clear that, one, I am not and I will never be a member of the PDP, to the extent that the PDP's only mantra in politics is, one, to rely on this primordial concept of zoning and rotation, and I have never believed in zoning and rotation. And I gave the members of the defunct NPN a hell of a tough time when they were advocating the same principle in 1978-79, before the coming of the Shagari administration, in which I was, of course, a participant and a parliamentary party leader of the then defunct PRP, with about 58 members of the House of Reps and 7 senators under my care and under my charge. Now, as far as I'm concerned, since I don't believe in zoning and rotation, and I don't even believe I speak for the North itself, because nobody asked me to speak. You can go to the elder, you know, some of the near blind and some of the other opportunities who talk supposedly on behalf of the North, but come around to collect money either from the president or from the National Security Advisor. I am not one of those people, and I hope I don't go through that degenerate stage in my life whereby I'd be lying on behalf of the North while coming here to collect money in Abuja. I'm not. So I do not believe in zoning and rotation, and I have no business explaining to you my stand. As far as I'm concerned, if the North wants to have the leadership of this country, Northerners and the North are still competitive. I believe it is simply an indication of the utter lousiness of the people who claim to be leaders of the North or so-called elders of the North, that today a Northerner is only relying on somebody presenting leadership to him on a platter of gold. If they want to continue that, tough luck to them. And that's why they go through the motion of internet agreements with people who are fundamentally dishonorable. My culture, and that's the fundamental Northern culture, says, and my religion also confirmed, that you should never enter into agreement, written or otherwise, with people who are fundamentally dishonorable. And the idea that some characters in the North who are self-appointed could now come and cry foul when the agreement which they entered to in private have not been honored by the people with whom they entered this agreement is, to me, laughable. Good luck to those of them who think they can make agreements with their fellow non-entities down south, and in the process of which they facilitate rigging and come into power. And when it is the turn of them to accept it, to be given leadership again on a platter of gold, they find that is not being availed to them. That is their own problem, not mine, madam. Please.
All right, Dr. Mohammed, on the 28th of February, Alhaji Babangida Tukur, national chairman of the PDP, was quoted in the Vanguard newspapers that there was nothing wrong with the PDP presenting President Goodluck Jonathan for elections in 2015, and that if other political parties don't like it, present their own. Shouldn't you be saying, well, if the PDP does it, that's their business? That means that other parties can come up with a better candidate, quote unquote, who will win. Or is it that whoever PDP presents wins? Why should we be bothered about who PDP presents?
The import of what you are saying, Mr. Uso, the import of what you are saying is that because the PDP is only one out of 63 or there, I don't know what the latest figure now, because the whole thing has become a joke. Since the PDP is a party and they assume they are an autonomous party, they can now go and present their candidate and be in the process disrespectful of the constitution of the country, be disrespectful of the constitution of their own party, present a candidate, use the corrupt and characters in INEC to rig the election, and then that will be home and free. That is all right by you, and or maybe that is all right by Babangida Tukur. It is not all right by me. And as far as I'm concerned, I represent the majority in this country, and have been older in politics than Babangida Tukur has been. And maybe I didn't have the money to rig election, but as far as I'm concerned, I am still a credible person in the North, even in Adamawa, his home state. And I can, if I want to go down memory lane, I can recount how he won the election of 1983. And I also can use evidence which was submitted in court. And I know some of the characters, a businessman in Kano and a retired police commissioner in who is also from Jigawa now, but living in Kano. I know how elections are rigged in this country. And as long as we continue to go on this rigmarole, you know, this yo-yo game of arguing ourselves when we do something dishonorable and unjust, and then blame the victims of our own dishonorable conduct on them, then we're not going to have meaningful democracy. Yeah, these people they are quoting are not the kind of people who I regard as shining examples of democrats. They are not democrats. And I don't like, also as a matter of policy, I don't like joining issues with people I regard as basically political and and literal illiterates.
All right, tell us if you will, where do the electorates come in here? Is it all about politicians because it's a democracy, isn't it? Or is it that the electorates no place yet for them in deciding who heads them?
Now, good question. I mean, what you just said now sums the dilemma of Nigerian democracy in the sense that at the end of the day, the electorates don't matter. That all that matters is that people who of influence and power and money and who also corner the privilege of appointing the election managers and who are also in charge of the police and the paramilitaries and of course the soldiers, especially in some of the more outreached areas, can now decide the fate of the country without having to consult you and me. And I believe politics, and especially electoral politics, which is what democracy is all about, is about letting the people decide who are going to be their leaders. But if you have been alive and well from 1999 to date, you know there has never been a credible election in Nigeria. And the worst election was the last election of 2011. And funny enough, nobody supported the election. In fact, the INEC itself had to cancel virtually everything that was supposed to be part of the election. One, they could not conduct the voter register. And if you know, as I know, elections are made or are made in the course of compiling the voter register. They had to postpone that three times. When the election was actually on, they had to postpone the election. And the process, they overreached themselves, moved on to reschedule the date, violating the constitutional provisions, which they had themselves requested from the National Assembly and which were inserted at their own explicit request. At the end of the day, what we had was nothing but a sham. But of course, we had people from the Western countries, Americas and Western Europe, who came for 1 week with a template that this was a free and fair election because some joker who I don't know what his connection with some of the secret services was supposed to be in charge of the election. But every Nigerian who is here, irrespective of party affiliation, wherever he had the election, knew that it was the worst election in the history of this country. And I have been conducting elections and winning them. I have been in public life and I sacrificed my career to go in public life. I'm older than any member of INEC today. I'm ahead of him in terms of education. I'm ahead of them in terms of political experience. There was no election in 2011. But we had the Western country because it suits their purpose, because they are not here because they like our democracy. They are here because they want our oil, they want our resources. And they want us to be subservient to Western capitalism. That's why they're here. And if we have 10 elections, which are the worst elections in the world, they'll still go ahead and accredit those elections and free and fair because they don't care about our own democracy. They only care about our own resources. And they have been calling dictators and similar characters and similar unsavory characters throughout the world. If it suits them to do so, they will do so with Nigerian democracy. But they are not democrats. They are only here for their own vital national interest. And if you are naive to believe that these Western countries are the only people who will guarantee your democracy, you are in for a rude shock.